High-throughput sequencing technologies produce huge amounts of data. These types of data can be helpful for answering many types of questions. For example,
what is the best flu vaccine to prepare for novel flu virus mutations? You could use structural proteomics data to answer this question.
What microorganisms live in our armpits or in our mouths? You could use high-throughput sequencing data that would be compared to a huge group of sequenced microbes in database to answer this question.
In what part of the world did my ancestors live? You could use high-throughput sequencing data to answer this question.
What genes are turned on and off as a worm develops from egg to adult? You could use transcriptomic data to answer this question.
Is there a kindness gene? You could use high-throughput sequencing data to answer this question.
Although these questions address a broad range of topics, they do have something in common. They all use huge omics data sets. High-throughput sequencing and other genomic techniques have allowed the collection of vast amounts of data from DNA and genomes, RNA data from transcriptomes, and information about all the proteins produced in organisms' proteomes. Bioinformaticians are critical for designing and running these omics experiments. Bioinformaticians are scientists with multidisciplinary training in computer science and biology. They are equipped to answer important biological questions based on analyzing and interpreting huge biologically based data sets. What do we mean by huge?
A typical single text message requires 190 bytes to store. An average teenager sends about 3,200 texts a month. A typical whole genome data set requires 100 gigabytes. To consume this much memory with text messages, you would have to save all messages for over 14,700 years. That's more than 565 million text messages. Now that is a lot of data.
Special high-powered computing resources are needed to deal with the storage, retrieval, processing, and analysis of all these omics data. Bioinformaticians are able to work on these high-performance clusters by logging in through their personal computers. Bioinformaticians can also work on internet-based tools and databases. Science advances by scientists having access to data and results from other scientists' experiments. The avalanche of data that genomics technologies have enabled has required the creation of new databases and methods to store and retrieve collected data and finished results. These databases and the algorithms they use are the handiwork of bioinformaticians. The really cool thing is that almost all of the databases used by scientists are available to anyone in the world who has web access. But let's back up. You need to design and run experiments to generate results that will be stored in these publicly available databases. Let's review the steps in a typical bioinformatics experiment.
Develop a question. Generate or get data. Develop computer tools to find patterns in the data that answer the question. Interpret the results. Communicate the results.
This process leads to some really interesting discoveries, which can lead, for example, to some important applications for health and medicine, improving food sources or energy supplies, conserving biodiversity. But not only are the results from these bioinformatics experiments potentially useful and interesting, but something about doing bioinformatics is fun and exciting for bioinformaticians, in their own words.
I use bioinformatics to find RNA zip codes, which are codes hidden in the RNA that tell a cell where the RNA belongs. Bioinformatics is exciting because you find out new things about the world every time you run your code.
I use bioinformatics to study how RNA is modified and made in a cell. Bioinformatics is exciting because it allows me to design algorithms to tackle some of these very large and complex biological data sets.
I use bioinformatics every day to look at DNA changes and identify why a person is sick. And bioinformatics is exciting because it helps me explain why my eyes are brown, why my friend thinks cilantro tastes like soap, and I hope to find out whether or not my baby cousin is going to develop a unibrow.
I use bioinformatics to find causal genetic mutations behind different diseases. Bioinformatics is exciting because it lets me be really creative in developing methods to solve a problem by looking at the bigger picture.
I use bioinformatics to study the genomes of domestic and endangered cats. Bioinformatics is exciting because I can make a major impact in the fight to save endangered species without leaving the comfort or safety of my home.
I use bioinformatics to understand how social insects, like these ants, form large and sophisticated societies through cooperative behavior. Bioinformatics is exciting because it provides me with powerful computational tools to study how the regulation of genes in an ant brain changes with age, novel environments, and social interactions.